Hey, Scott.
Let me see you lean forward. A minute ago, you just pulled your hair back. Can I see you do that again?
Don't you bite me. She was looking lovinger.
Best one already, right?
Mm-hmm.
What else do you want? You want a foot or something?
Why don't you pick it up a little bit and just pet it? Solid foot. Stand by.
Are you trying to get it?
Your hand down, actually? No. Action?
When's the funeral?
11.
Okay, we're resetting.
Well, at least
yeah.
At least
do
open them up.
I do it backwards.
Take it.
Can I open a little more? Keep opening it. Try to get that.
Huh?
Try to get that window out of there.
Yeah.
Oh shit.
How'd he die?
Died at a party. I don't know what he's doing.
You had other friends die? How do you know Jenny? When's the last time you saw her? Long time. Weird seeing her again? I'm gonna ask you a couple more questions. And I'm gonna ask you if you knew Corey. After I ask that, Ashley, you're cold. So you're going to say, I'm cold. And you're going to head to the stairs. When you head to the stairs, you guys will follow, okay? And so you'll clear for me. All right, so I'm going to ask a couple more questions.
Wait, did we know Corey?
You did, because you know Jenny. But you don't probably remember him very well. You say, you're going to say,
yep.
You're going to say, I'm cold. Yeah, you can look at them and be like, I'm cold. All right. How old are you? Same. So you're in 10th grade? And you like school? You all live around here? Walking distance? How'd you know Jenny? Did you know her brother? I think the only thing I would change is maybe...
I'll take out the ones that I feel like... Yeah, no, we're not eating it anyways. We can have it.
Close that door gently while we have it.
Alright, we're ready.
My camera's powering down. You want to see the four?
Yeah.
Come a little bit camera right.
Yep.
Who are you?
Maybe mine.
Punch in a little closer?
I'd stay here and then. I'd do the whole thing.
Yeah. Okay, stand by, quiet, please.
Camera speed.
I don't think there's any fixing it with good parenting. I think. I think if you have this thing, I don't want it for my kids, the younger ones. I don't want it for them. I don't want the same thing for them.
Is there a point where you, did you ever give up on Corey?
Yeah, I did. I mean, I gave up on him, and then he went to jail, and he had that little bit of sobriety, and I felt like, wow, I gave up too soon. I felt like there's hope, and, you know, maybe he can get better, and, you know, maybe if when he gets out, he just changes his friends, and, you know, if he comes back home, and, but then, you know, he got out, and I didn't see him, and I heard he was using, and I know what that means. I mean, it's not that I gave up on Corey, it's that I know that Corey wasn't there anymore. When the drug was there, Corey wasn't even there anymore. It was as if he was dead before he was dead, you know? I can't explain it any better than that. It's just that it was like he wasn't even there. It was like his body was a shell that housed this addiction. And Corey was gone. You know, I feel like everyone says, you know, she must not have loved him. She's not crying. She doesn't seem like, you know, a mother who has just lost her son. But I have cried nights for years, you know, mourning him, mourning his life. You know, he's been dying to me and dead to me for a long time. And now I'm just exhausted. I'm just tired. Faith in what? You know, it seems nothing could change this course. I feel like maybe there's luck. You know, like maybe with Marina and James, there'll be luck. This won't happen to them. This will skip them. I don't know about faith. I mean, for me, I feel sometimes I could have gone the way that my brother went. And for me, I'm not sure that it did skip me. I feel like I stopped it somehow. And so faith, maybe faith for me that I cannot go back. You know, that I can keep doing what I'm doing and that I can stay sober. And, but for my children, I don't know. I don't know. If you're asking about faith in a God, I'm like thinking, okay, but this God has to be an imperfect God, because this God can't be a God that did this to us. Because then it's a really shitty God, you know?
Let's skew it towards me.
Towards
oh wait, am I going to lose that? Yeah. Let's skew it. Like, I want a camera right here.
I think I imagined that.
Okay. A little closer.
Yeah.
Excuse me.
Getting
the third one. Thank you twice. Okay. Yes. Okay.
So Jeff, I'm gonna ask you to ask like a couple questions. Like I'm gonna ask you to ask him a couple questions in the scene. The film's kind of about him.
Remember when Travis shaved his head? Yeah. It starts.
Travis Bickle?
Yeah, Travis Bickle.
Man, and he's not suffering. He don't have no pain. So we're gonna take this to the limit. You know what he would want us to do. Let's get down.
All right, well, I got two of the prettiest girls in the place going to sing him a song now. Is that right? All right, here we go.
This is the song with me from...
There are three that are being unused, one for that's for the living room front and family room, and one for the kitchen and basement steps.
This is a really nice sleeping bag. Very lucky to have it. It's a gift from my wife.
see this thing?
I was really nervous about the idea of taking this. I found it in Austin, Texas, and taking it back on the plane, because it, I feel like it just looks like it's filled with, a key of coke. But, so I shipped it from Austin to here. Rolls. Amy named it. My girlfriend, but I can't remember what she named it.